I thought I knew pretty much everything about amusement parks and defunct amusement parks in the area of Lehigh Valley, Pennsylvania, but I just recently became aware of a defunct amusement park that I never knew existed. It's an amusement park that's, like many others, developed more or less at the end of a trolley line or by a trolley company to entertain people on weekends. It's called Island Park or Greater Island Park. Located just out to the west of Easton, Pennsylvania, in the middle of the Lehigh River. Perhaps I could narrow down the location for those more familiar with the area. If you wanted to get there from, let's say, Allentown, you would head east on I-78 to Route 33 and then go north on Route 33. And the very first exit on 33 North is Freemansburg Avenue. You'd get off there, head east to Hope Road, and travel down Hope Road to a boat launch, which is directly under the Route 33 bridge that you just traveled on. Now, if you were to have a boat and you launched yourself from that boat launch a couple hundred yards to the east down the Lehigh River, you'd come across Smith's Island, as it's known officially, but it was called Island Park. Another way one could view this is if one came through Hugh Moore Park, where the Joshua White canal boat ride is. And if you rode your bike along the canal, you'd keep riding up, and off to your right is Chain Dam. And as you get further up, you see the Lock Tender's House. And this is where the canal path ends at the Lehigh River. Now, if you look straight up, you'd see the eastern end of this 100-acre Smith's Island, where Island Park was once located. There's very little to be seen there today, but there are some remnants. This cable overhead, for instance, it was part of a chain walkway. This is where canal barge operators would walk their mules in order to get to the barges, and they'd shuttle back and forth there. As for the park itself, now greatly overgrown, it was built in July 1894. And it existed for about 25 years up until 1919. They gave up on the park at that point because of various ice floes knocking out trolley service. Oh, that's right, I didn't tell you. They had trolley service. A trolley would shuttle every 5 minutes between the island and the southern area of the embankment of the river. And this would provide passengers with trips to see concerts, vaudeville performances. They had an open-air theater, and it was known as the casino. It also had a band shell. At one time, it was said John Philip Sousa actually performed there. But like I said, the ice floes kept wrecking the trolley trestle, and they got tired of it, and they sort of figured out this isn't the greatest location, obviously, for an amusement park. They did have the merry-go-round. The merry-go-round you see here, it was moved over to Bushkill Park, now a defunct park as well, but that's where the merry-go-round ended up, and of course now it's not in good shape either. There's actually not a whole lot more I know about the park other than doing the research that I have done on it. These wonderful pictures. I have links as to the source of the photos and some more information if you care to check that out. But one of the things that should be mentioned here and pointed out is that there's been talk of taking away the Chain Dam. First of all, this would be an absolute travesty because, number one, the current Chain Dam was not the original dam when the park was located there. Actually, the original Chain Dam was located just a little bit upstream to the west, and it was known as Dam Number 8. It really didn't have a name. It was Dam Number 8, the last dam that would provide water for the canal system before it joined the Delaware River. It was the last stretch. Now, if you remove this dam, that puts a crimp on the boating launch because obviously you wouldn't be able to boat anymore. Neither would the Bethlehem Boat Club. In fact, that would remove any boating possibilities, most likely, at least motorized boats, between the chain dam where it currently sits, going all the way back into just about Bethlehem near Sand Island. I know we've got a real zeal to remove dams, but, well, we already lost the Island Park, and we lost a lot of history already, It's very beautiful with the dam backed up, but, you know, progress? Who knows? This may one day be history, just like the park was. I know we're really in a hurry to move these dams off, but I think there's going to be a lot of disappointed people, and one more piece of history that's gone. So enjoy it if you can get down there now before it's all taken away. I kind of think it's not going to happen, but, well, you never know. Right now, they're removing some 3,000 dams in Pennsylvania. Like, it's the hottest thing going right now. And what a shame. Another historical thing. Maybe another piece of history that will never be able to be seen as we see it today. But nonetheless, just thought I'd let you know and share a little bit with you about a new amusement park that I found. A new old amusement park. Island Park. Easton, Pennsylvania. One time, I think Umore Park wanted to reestablish something out there, but I think with the flooding possibilities and otherwise, maybe when the dam's gone, if they'd ever take it down, maybe they'll restore it, and maybe it can be, but I'd prefer to just keep the chain dam up there and look out over history, and that little cable suspension from the bridge that once existed. Then that's just me, and thanks for watching the video.